Sing to the Lord, you saints of his. Praise his holy name. For his anger lasts only a moment, but his favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping might remain for a night, but rejoicing comes in the morning. Please stand for our first hymn, which you will find in the insert in your bulletin. remain standing, and you will find the liturgy for Moravian Music Sunday in your bulletin. O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us give thanks to the Father, who has enabled us to share in the inheritance of the saints in light.
He has rescued us from the power of darkness,
and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the
forgiveness of sins. In him all things in heaven and on earth were created.
Let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts, to which indeed we were called in the one body. Thanks for every good gift. On this day especially, we thank you for your creative gifts to us, which cause us to enrich our lives and experience through science and art, literature and drama, words and music. We thank you especially for your gifts to the Moravian Church, devotion to the Savior, simplicity, our strong sense of community and fellowship, and our long-standing dedication to spreading your gospel.
May
Inspire and bless those who write and compose, those who play and sing, those who lead and teach. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant us to live in harmony with one another in accordance with Christ Jesus.
I'd like to invite the other young people to come down and join me. Good morning. I'm grateful it's not snowing this morning, like yesterday, huh? So, today, of course, is a special day, and all of you are participating in it in terms of music and singing. I'm just wondering, how many of you have ever sang Morning Star for either? Well, look at that. Okay. So now that we have Morning Star soloists, they sing at Christmas Eve services and at the Children's Love Feast. That's a fair number of you. So I'm just wondering, how many of you out there have ever sang that as soloists in church? Oh, look at that. Yeah, here we go. Ah, Will Kitchen's up in the balcony. He's admitting it grudgingly. I'll pick on him for a minute. So I figured out that over the probably the last 25 years, every year there are 16 Morning Star soloists. That's about 400 young people that have sung that solo in the last 25 years. Now, Will is a perfect example of this. You can't get out of it, could you, Will? No, he couldn't do it. So, because it's more than likely if you grow up in this church, whether you have been gifted by God with the voice of an angel or you sound like me, you're probably going to end up having that opportunity. And the reason I raise that today is because it is the most important thing about today like today is reminding us that this music is inside of all of us, and it's a gift from God. And it's important that we share that joyfully with the world. And so we're so grateful that you participate in this, that you, as you grow up, have that opportunity and that you share that with the entire congregation, and we hope that you continue to share it throughout your life. Thank you for coming up. Junior choir is to remain. Thank you.
Our scripture lesson this morning comes from the book of Revelation. These verses are found towards the very end of the final book of the Bible. The setting is that heavenly worship that surrounds God in heaven. "Behold, I am coming soon. My reward is with me, and I will give to everyone according to what he has done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may go through the gates into the city. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to give you this testimony for the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David and the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, 'Come,' and let him who hears say, 'Come.' Whoever is thirsty, let him come, and whoever wishes, let him take the free gift of the water of life." May the Lord add his blessing to our reading of his word. Worship is the most important thing that we all do together. It is where we gather as a family, as a church community. It is here that we offer our praise and thanksgiving to God, and it is here that we are strengthened by that act of gathering together to participate in doing this. It is the breath of a living faith. And music is central to that. We are blessed as a congregation in that we have a wealth of musically talented individuals, people who joyfully share those gifts with us. I learned a long time ago, if I pay close attention in a worship service, that God shows up. Sometimes I'm not so sure, but God does show up. In fact, it's interesting because God shows up in all kinds of different places. It may be during the liturgy. It may be in a moment of prayer. Sometimes, very rarely, and though I really doubt it, the sermon. But most of the time, for me, where God shows up in worship are those times when I feel the presence of the Holy Spirit. It's within the music. It's where I get that tingle on the back of my neck, where my heart is taken to another place. And it can be a verse in one of our hymns. It can be the anthem of the adult choir. It can be our young people up singing with their choirs. It can be a prelude, or it can be the offertory. It can be one of our young people playing an instrument for us. But in those moments, and when they happen, I don't know how many times I have often whispered to Reader, "We can go home now." Experiencing the presence of the Almighty God is a very important value for us. God is a precious thing, like water for the thirsty and food for the hungry. And so we need to be grateful for those moments that God is here. We also need to remember that it's not just the music that occurs in here, it's the music that we take out in our lives. It's so appropriate. I, just this past week, got a message from one of our high school students, and she's told me this. She said, "I had to let you know that I was in my car tonight. I was driving to dinner with a friend, and I decided to put in my Sing and Play VBS CD." Some of the songs we're all singing today. "And so as I began to scream sing," that means she's singing really, really loud, "'He's the King, must be done in love, and let us pray,' I am sure that I got from him the strangest look I have ever received." Matt, is that how everyone looks at us? Don't other people have as much fun as we do? She's raising a very important thing. The music of our faith should be the music of our lives, and we should carry it with us everywhere we go. And so we need to be thankful to God for that gift. We need to be thankful for the people who share that gift with us. To all our choir members, to Ryan, who got up at 4 o'clock this morning to get here to be prepared, to Peggy and Cheryl, who accompany us in worship, for Kim and all of her efforts, to all of you who raise your voices in song, bless you and thank you for helping us run into God now and then. Amen. At this time, I'd like to invite our ushers to serve us for the morning offering.
These gifts this morning, we are thankful for your presence here with us and for the music that you put in our hearts. We would ask that you continue to be with us and that your Spirit guide us in the use of these gifts so that we may bring honor to your name which we bear. We are aware that there are those who cannot be with us this morning because they are ill or suffering or traveling to be with loved ones. We ask that you bring them healing, peace, and safe travel. We ask these things in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated.
Words of life, words of hope, give us strength, help us grow. In this world where'er we roam, ancient words will guide us.
Thank you.
choir that big, it takes a while to get them back to their seats. Please stand for hymn number 532. Which transcends all understanding. Keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you always. Amen.